Welcome to 365 Christian Men, where every day we aim to inspire and encourage with real-life stories about men. August 31st, Andy Kellywood. Andy Kellywood was the maintenance man for Navajo Ministries. He was the type of guy who was eager to help a person in need. In today's story, the director of Navajo Ministries had his hands full with three troublesome boys who would regularly sneak out at night and cause all sorts of mischief. In an effort to discipline the boys, the director assigned them to work for Andy every morning that summer. Here's what happened.
When you trust an untested man, he can grow to pass the test. The first day Andy had the three troublemakers on his maintenance crew, he lined them up and pointed to a patch of weeds. That day, it was over 90 degrees outside. The work was dusty, monotonous, and backbreaking. The boys wiped sweat on their shirt sleeves, but not once did they complain. For a whole week, they persevered. At first, Andy stayed close. As they proved themselves, he left periodically to show they had earned his trust. The next week, Andy introduced the boys to the push mower used to care for more than an acre of lawn. He taught them to check the oil and gas, explained the mowing pattern, and then pulled the cord. The engine rumbled to life. The boys took turns. When the grass clippings filled the bag, he showed them how to empty them into the front end bucket on the blue tractor. Then he drove the tractor to the dumpster, deposited the clippings, and taught the boys to reattach the bag. After the lawn was finished, he told them to refill the mower's gas tank. The boys seemed to be getting more engaged, but the day he led them to the blue tractor really drew them in. "Do you want to drive?" Their eyes widened in shock. He was going to trust them with the tractor? At the same time, both fear and excitement flitted across their faces. Andy invited Casey to climb onto the driver's seat and showed him where to place his hands and feet. The others watched as he taught Casey to turn on the tractor and put it into the low, low gear. The rhythm of the engine matched the slow speed of Casey's first drive, and Andy walked right next to him. Once Casey had control, Andy put the tractor in a higher gear. As Andy repeated the process with the others, eagerness sparked in their eyes. They became proficient, their grins widened. Then they learned their favorite part, how to release the bucket so the clippings fell into the dumpster. As summer progressed, Andy gave them more responsibility. When one task was finished, they asked what else needed to be done, and they stayed past their mandatory work hours. The boys took ownership of their work. When water lines broke, they put their backs into digging through the hard earth, even breaking concrete to help with the repairs. Andy knew their work was not only an investment in Navajo Ministries, but also in the boys' futures. He watched for opportunities to teach them new skills. They changed oil, brakes, and rotors on the ministry's vehicles. And when it was time for new tires, he taught them to shop for the best price so no one would overcharge them. Andy said, "If you ever get a car, then you know what to do." Once summer was over, the boys found Andy after school and asked if they could help him. They were standing taller, Andy said. Half Navajo and half Laguna Pueblo, Andy knew what it was like to struggle to grow up, navigate through multiple cultures, and get into trouble. When he blew it, he had no one to talk to. But it's different for these boys. They talk to him. Andy loves planting good into their futures, and to plant that one little seed has Andy standing taller too. Mark 4:8 says, "But other seed fell on good ground and yielded a crop that sprang up, increased, and produced." Is there someone in your life that you can sow into and help grow? When you trust an untested man, he can grow to pass the test.
Thank you for listening to today's story. Every day of the year, our hope is to inspire you with real-life stories of faithful men who have gone before us. Today's story was about a man who isn't as well known as some, but his story proves that God uses ordinary men in many different ways to accomplish his purposes. Is there a man whose story has inspired you, but most people have never heard his story? We would like to hear his story and maybe include him in 365 Christian Men. Please visit our website to share the story of a man who has inspired you and join us tomorrow at 365christianmen.com.